We want to use a distributive property to simplify the given expressions. So here we have 5 times the quantity x plus 2. So we need to multiply the 5 and the x as well as the 5 and the 2. And sometimes you'll hear distribution referred to as multiplication across addition or subtraction, and this is why. So we'll have 5 times x plus 5 times 2. Well, 5 times x would be 5x, and 5 times 2 is equal to 10, so we have 5x plus 10. In the second example, we're distributing positive 3, so we'll have positive 3 times x minus positive 3 times 9. So we'll have 3 times x minus 3 times 9. Well, 3 times x is equal to 3x minus 3 times 9 is equal to 27. Let's go and take a look at 2 more examples. Here we have 2 times the quantity 3y plus 7. So we'll distribute the 2, so we'll have 2 times 3y plus 2 times 7. Well, 2 times 3y would be 6y, and 2 times 7 is equal to 14. So we have 6y plus 14. And for the last example, we have negative 3 times the quantity n minus 4. So we're distributing negative 3. So we'll have negative 3 times n minus negative 3 times 4. And we need to be a little careful when distributing a negative and we have subtraction. So we'll have negative 3 times n minus negative 3 times 4. So negative 3 times n is negative 3n. And here we have to be careful. We're going to have minus negative 3 times 4, which would be minus negative 12. But remember, subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive. So this becomes plus positive 12. So we should be a little extra careful when distributing a negative and we have subtraction. Another way to remember this is plus 12, we can think of this as negative 3 times negative 4, which would be a positive 12.